At this point, you should be familiar with personas and wireframes. Your next task is to create at least one persona and a user flow. You can lay out your persona on a piece of paper like this, split up into four quadrants. Your persona should include the following information: a sketch of the person or a picture of the person and their name, demographic information, and any behaviors that you think are relevant to your product. Here you should include demographic information that leads to specific types of behaviors. And here you should put their pain points and their needs. Try to differentiate personas around pain points, needs, and their behaviors. By designing your product for different behaviors or their different pain points and needs, you could really target different users. And finally, here's where your product comes into play. This is where you put all your solutions for that user. You can create this persona using any tool of your choice, and I've included some additional tools and examples which are linked in the instructor notes. You can rely on user research here to help you out. Remember, the goal is to create something quickly. You can revisit this persona that you create and the user flow when you learn about design sprints in lesson 3. Create a persona and include a user flow that shows how a user would complete a task and how the user would interact in the main navigation or flows of your product. You can see one example of this, which is linked in the instructor notes.